So the Worldwide Developers Conference, or WWDC, is right around the corner, and the whole world is anticipating some major announcements from Apple, especially after the repeated calls to its CEO Tim Cook to make Siri great again. And we all know by now that Apple likes to work in silence, without the big announcements and excitement that we often see from AI giants like OpenAI, Google, and X.AI when they release a new model. But now, the release of Apple's ReALM model has taken the industry by surprise, especially since Apple is claiming that ReALM can substantially outperform Microsoft-backed OpenAI's popular large language model GPT-4 in understanding and handling prompts under different contexts. So does OpenAI need to watch out because Apple is finally jumping on the AI chatbots bandwagon? Are there any indications that ReALM will be integrated within Siri, making it better at understanding and responding to complex conversations? Let's find out. Apple researchers have developed an AI model named ReALM, or Reference Resolution as Language Modeling, that aims to radically enhance how voice assistants like Siri understand and respond to commands. ReALM's primary mission is to enhance language understanding by tackling a common challenge, resolving ambiguous references. And surely you may be wondering what this means. Well, imagine going through your Instagram feed, and then suddenly you start a conversation with Siri. "Hey Siri, help me book a flight to visit this place." With Siri's current capabilities, don't be surprised if it gives you links to known flight booking websites with no context and no particular destination. How can Siri know what you mean by this place? Well, with ReALM, Siri can now decipher context, ensuring that this place means the place where the photo displayed on the screen was taken. How convenient is this? Is Siri evolving to become a pro at solving linguistic mysteries? In their groundbreaking research, Apple has introduced an innovative approach to improve how AI understands and reacts with users. Their latest model, ReALM, focuses on a key issue called reference resolution. This term might sound complex, but it essentially means helping the AI to understand what you are referring to in a conversation, even when it's not explicitly stated. Consider this scenario. You're browsing through movie titles on your smart TV. You find one you like, and you address your AI assistant saying, "Save this movie, we'll watch it tonight." Traditional AI systems might not realize that "this" refers to the specific movie you're viewing on your screen. This ambiguity can lead to confusion and ineffective responses from the AI. ReALM, however, is designed to grasp such contextual cues, recognizing that "this" points to the movie on your screen, thus enabling a more accurate and relevant response. It's like giving your AI assistant, like Siri, the ability to peek over your shoulder and see exactly what you're looking at, making interactions feel more natural and intuitive. This advancement could transform everyday tasks. Imagine you're looking at a recipe on your tablet and ask Siri, "How do I make this?" Instead of just searching the web for generic cooking methods, Siri, powered by ReALM, would understand you're referring to the specific recipe on your screen and provide tailored instructions or even video tutorials directly related to that dish. By tackling these conversational challenges, Apple's ReALM is not just enhancing Siri's capabilities, but is setting the stage for more sophisticated and helpful AI interactions across all Apple devices. Now, to understand how Apple's AI model ReALM improves upon traditional AI systems, it's essential to grasp the mechanics behind its innovative approach to contextual comprehension. Traditional language models, such as GPT-4, utilize vast databases and parsing techniques that may incorporate multimodal data, including text, images, and audio messages, to generate responses. However, these models often face challenges with efficiency and accuracy in real-time applications, primarily when used in dynamic, everyday scenarios. Apple's ReALM model simplifies AI processing by converting all contextual inputs, both visual and textual, into a consistent, text-based format. This approach streamlines the processing requirements by avoiding the complexities of image recognition technologies, which typically demand significant computing resources. Considering that mobile devices, where voice assistants often operate, have limited computational power, focusing exclusively on text allows ReALM to operate within these constraints. By reducing the size of the model and focusing on text processing, ReALM enhances its efficiency and accuracy, ensuring quicker and more reliable responses from the AI. Furthermore, one of the pivotal improvements in ReALM is its approach to reducing AI hallucinations, a flop commonly seen in AI chatbots, where they generate incorrect or nonsensical information. Apple addresses this issue by implementing constraints in the decoding process and employing refined post-processing techniques. These methods help ensure that the AI's output remains relevant and accurate to the given context, significantly enhancing user trust and reliability. For example, Imagine a user asking their device, "What's the weather like there?" while looking at a travel blog post about Paris. Traditional AI models might mistakenly provide the weather for the user's current location or ask for clarification about there. However, ReALM utilizes its refined contextual understanding to recognize that there refers to Paris, as indicated by the content on the screen. It then proceeds to deliver the weather report for Paris without needing further input from the user. This capability demonstrates ReALM's ability to parse and respond accurately to indirect references, enhancing the interaction quality and user trust in the system. Apple's research indicates that ReALM is designed to recognize and differentiate between three types of entities: on-screen, conversational, and background. On-screen entities are those visible on the user's device, such as images or text on a website. Conversational entities are derived from the dialogue's context, like understanding that a user asking about today's workout refers to a specific routine in a pre-established workout schedule. And background entities encompass elements that are not directly displayed or discussed, but are relevant to the user's current activity, such as a podcast playing in the background that the user may reference during a conversation. These capabilities allow ReALM to provide highly personalized and context-aware interactions, enabling devices to act more like knowledgeable assistants rather than simple query-responding machines. For instance, if a user is multitasking on their device, such as listening to a podcast while emailing, and they ask a question about something mentioned in the podcast, ReALM can accurately identify the reference and provide the needed information without disrupting the user's workflow. This sophisticated understanding of different contexts sets ReALM apart in the landscape of AI advancements, promising a future where digital interactions are as intuitive and natural as conversations with a human. Now, aside from making Siri great again, well, not yet though, but hopefully soon, here are five applications and use cases of Apple's ReALM model. Number 1. Mobile apps. ReALM's improved understanding of context could change the way messaging apps manage complicated conversations. This makes it easier for users to keep their conversations flowing smoothly without confusion. For personal assistants, ReALM could make interactions much more natural, allowing chatbots and virtual assistants to understand and answer user questions with remarkable accuracy. Number 2. Content recommendation systems. Content platforms like news aggregators could use ReALM to better match content with what users are interested in by picking up on the subtle details of their interactions and preferences. For music and video streaming services, this means that recommendations could go beyond past viewing habits to include the context in which users enjoyed specific songs or shows, making these suggestions more personalized. Number 3. Search engines and information retrieval. In the world of search engines and information retrieval, ReALM could refine algorithms to better interpret the intent behind user queries, providing more relevant search results. For question answering systems, this enhanced capability means delivering more precise answers that consider the user's full query context, thus improving the reliability of information retrieval. Number 4. Healthcare applications. ReALM could also have significant implications in healthcare, particularly in managing electronic health records, or EHR, and assisting in clinical decision support systems. By accurately interpreting the context of patient data and past medical interactions, ReALM could ensure that healthcare providers receive contextually relevant information, leading to better patient outcomes. Number 5. Social media platforms. For social media platforms, ReALM could improve the moderation of comments by understanding the context in which comments are made, helping to maintain healthy community interactions. It could also enhance automated replies to posts by considering the entire conversation thread, thus fostering more meaningful engagements. So, as Apple's WWDC conference approaches, there's a lot of speculation about whether Apple will announce the integration of ReALM into Siri. Given Apple's pattern of gradual and strategic enhancements to their technologies, it's plausible that ReALM's advanced context understanding capabilities might soon revolutionize Siri's performance. Looking forward, ReALM's potential applications span various sectors, from mobile apps to healthcare, promising more intuitive interactions and smarter AI responses across devices. This could mark a significant milestone in making digital assistants truly understand and anticipate user needs, potentially setting a new standard for AI interaction. Now we turn to you. What do you think of the potential Siri upgrade? Are you excited to try it out when it becomes available? Let us know in the comments section below. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe for more AI breakthroughs.